Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, was established in 2003. The act that established the commission gives it powers to arrest, investigate, and prosecute all economic and financial crimes offenders. Hello and welcome to the program, The Eagle. My name is Aisha Gambari.
And I am Aisha Mohammed. Good evening, viewers, and thanks for joining us on the program.
EFCC will get you anywhere, anytime.
The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, was established in 2003 by the administration of former President Olusegun Obasanjo. The creation of the commission was born out of the determination of the federal government to sanitize the Nigerian economic environment by enforcing all economic and financial crimes laws. Kamilu Gebi, in this edition, will bring you a report on the milestones achieved by the commission since inception.
The Consulate General of the Federal Republic of Germany in Lagos, Ingo Habert, has assured the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, of regular training opportunities for its staff. He gave the assurance in Lagos at the presentation of certificate of participant to 9 operatives of the EFCC, who together with participants from other law enforcement agencies benefited from a 7-day capacity building program facilitated by the German government.
The EFCC has arraigned a Pastor Emmanuel Anga and Atim Victor Generous before Justice Abubakar Joro of the Gombe State High Court, Gombe, on a 2-count charge bordering on conspiracy and obtaining by false pretense.
And Golden Ago will represent to you a report which seeks to know who is more corrupt between a man and a woman.
Please stay tuned as the program continues after the break. Don't go away.
Mark, I don't need pay.
For me to buy correct motor, for me to take neck manual.
Mark, I don't need pay. Mark, I don't need pay.
Welcome back. The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, was established in 2002 by the administration of former President Olusegun Obasanjo. The creation of the commission was born out of the determination of the federal government to sanitize the Nigeria economic environment by enforcing all financial crimes laws. Kamila Gebi brings you this report that highlights the milestones achieved by the commission. The report.
Nigeria, the most populous black nation on earth, had its image dented and economy on a downward spiral due to the fraudulent activities of advance fee fraudsters, also known as 419, corruption, and lack of accountability and transparency in the public and private sectors. Businesses crashed and infrastructure decayed as funds meant for developmental purposes were diverted for private use or stashed abroad. The EFCC was therefore created to reform and reposition the country to the path of sustainable development by investigating and enforcing all laws against economic and financial crime offenders. Since its creation, the Commission has successfully carried out this mandate with several milestones recorded, some of which include the delisting of Nigeria from the list of non-cooperative countries and territories, NCCT, by the Financial Action Task Force, FATF, in June 2006, sanitization of the banking sector, arrest and prosecution of advance fee fraudsters, known as 419. The Commission also waged war against cybercrime perpetrators, also known as Yahoo Yahoo Boys, The Commission's law enforcement activities have also helped in redeeming the country's international image as a responsible member of the Committee of Nations. Despite its commendable strides, there are still citizens who remain critical of the Commission. Some accuse it of being selective in its investigations, while others claim it allows itself to be used as a tool for witch hunt. But the vast majority of Nigerians appreciate the contributions of the agency. As they frequently say, the fear of the EFCC is the beginning of wisdom.
EFCC will get you anywhere, anytime.
The commission was at inception headed by Nuhu Ribadu. Ribadu served as chairman until 2007 and was succeeded in 2008 by Farida Waziri. Waziri was appointed executive chairman of the EFCC on May 15, 2008. She resumed work on June 6, 2008 after being sworn in with all members of her board. Waziri was, however, removed as chairman of the EFCC by former President Goodluck Jonathan after serving about 3.5 years. She was replaced by the immediate past chairman Ibrahim Lamorde in February 2012. On the 11th of November 2015, Lamorde handed over the helms of affairs to Ibrahim Mustafa Magu as acting chairman after the presidency announced his removal. Due to the unrelenting effort of the commission in the war against graft in the country, the EFCC has become a reference point among law enforcement agencies both at home and abroad through the professionalism of its workforce. This is evidenced in the number of cases pending in courts and those successfully prosecuted. With the conviction record of 126 achieved in 2014, the commission has projected to raise the bar by the end of 2015. If the number of convictions is unprecedented, the success recorded in the area of asset recovery beggars description. Between 2010 and 2014, the sum of over 65 billion naira was recovered. Also recovered are the sum of over 600,000 pound sterlings and another sum of 62,600 euros recovered from criminals. Surely, the commission is not clicking glasses yet over these feats. Towards the realization of its sensitization and enlightenment mandate, the EFCC has embarked on a vigorous nationwide sensitization campaign against corruption and why Nigerians must shun it. In order to ensure that only the best are offered employment into the commission, the recruitment process was also reviewed. Several measures, including aptitude tests, interviews, polygraph tests, and vetting of candidates' certificates and background, among others, were introduced. Priority is also given to staff training and retraining, with many employees benefiting from local and international training programs. The intervention of some donor agencies have been invaluable in this regard. The Commission also enjoys tremendous support in the areas of equipment, investigation, and training of its personnel from foreign law enforcement agencies. Recently, the French Embassy in Nigeria, led by the police attaché, Eric Bonichan, donated 8 laptops to the Commission as part of its support to strengthening the Commission's quest to rid the country of economic and financial crimes. Apart from the French Embassy, the Metropolitan Police also visited the Commission. Jonathan Benton, head Proceeds of International Corruption Unit, who led the delegation, said they were at the Commission to further strengthen existing relationships with the EFCC in the area of investigation. The Met Police is known to have supported the Commission in various investigations, one of which is that of former Governor of Delta State, James Ibori, who is serving a 13-year jail term in London. In December 2014, the Western Australia Police signed a Memorandum of Understanding, MOU, to work together to combat internet fraud and money laundering with the EFCC. This partnership led to the arrest of one Orowo Jesse Omoko, a 28-year-old undergraduate of University of Ibadan, who allegedly obtained the sum of $90,000 from one Mrs. Jette Jacob, an Australian based in Johannesburg, South Africa, in a fake romance scam. The victim later died in mysterious circumstances. Other foreign agencies with which the Commission enjoys robust partnership include the Global Fund, U.S. Federal Trade Commission, U.S. Postal Inspection Service, the World Bank, African Development Bank, British Serious Fraud Office, Economic Crimes Network, and Australia Federal Police. The Commission has also signed agreements for the establishment of the Economic Crime Agency Network, comprising London Police, Corrupt Practices Investigation Bureau of Singapore, European Anti-Fraud Office, Hong Kong's Independent Commission Against Corruption, the US FBI, the Malaysia Anti-Corruption Commission, New Zealand Serious Fraud Office, the Indonesia Corruption Eradication Commission, as well as the UK National Crime Agency. With these and other achievements too numerous to mention, the EFCC has rekindled hope that the nation is on the right track as far as the war on corruption is concerned.
Welcome back. The Consulate General of the Federal Republic of Germany in Lagos, Ingo Habert, has assured the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, of regular training opportunities for its staff. He gave the assurance in Lagos at the presentation of certificate of participant of 9 operatives of the EFCC, who together with participants from other law enforcement agencies benefited from a 7-day capacity building program facilitated by the German government. Relike Odofin Jolayemi reports.
The other agencies are the Department of State Services, DSS, National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLEA, and National Agency for the Prohibition of Trafficking in Persons, NAPTIP. At the closing session of the training, Herbert promised that adequate training will be offered to staff of the EFCC and other agencies on request. The training, Basics of Operational Analysis, was geared towards equipping investigators with the right analytical skills for better performance in investigations and crime detection. It commenced on Tuesday, November 17, 2015, and lasted 7 days. EFCC's head of operations in Lagos, Mr. Elias Ukwabai, commended the German government for offering the participants the opportunity. Rolake Odofin Jolayemi, reporting for The Eagle.
The program is The Eagle. The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, has arraigned a Pastor Emmanuel Anga and Atim Victor Generous before Justice Abubakar Joru of the Gombe State High Court, Gombe, on 2 counts charged bordering on conspiracy and obtaining by false pretense. Golden Agu reports.
Anga and Generous are alleged to have in November 2013 deceived one David Madison into believing that they were employees of a foreign exchange business, Gora Commanding Resources, which they claimed belonged to another suspect, Philemon Gora, who is still at large. The victim was said to have been lured into believing that his investment of 500,000 naira would yield 10% as returns on a monthly basis. He, however, discovers later that the 10% on his capital reflected on his account only in the first month. All attempts to get his money back, however, proved abortive. The accused persons pleaded not guilty when the charges were read to them. Their trial has since commenced before the same court. Also arraigned by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission was one Tajuddin Abdullahi before Justice Lawal Wada of the Kano State High Court on a 5-count charge bordering on criminal breach of trust and forgery. The complainant alleged that he instructed the accused person sometimes in September 2011 to transfer the sum of over $140,000 to one of his customers, Huzo Fuxin, who owns a weaving and dyeing company in China. The accused claimed that the money was transferred to Fuxin through one of the New Generation banks on September 20, 2015. However, the telegraphic instrument presented as proof of the transfer was allegedly forged. The accused pleaded not guilty to the charges when they were read to him. The prosecution counsel, M.S. Abubakar, asked the court to fix a date for the commencement of trial. Justice Wada presented the accused person bail in the sum of 2 million naira and 2 sureties in like sum. The sureties must be civil servants on grade level 12 with landed properties. The matter was adjourned to December 8, 2015 for trial. In a related development, the EFCC also arraigned one Reverend Dame Boat before Justice Nuhu Galadanchi of Kano State High Court on a 3-count charge bordering on criminal breach of trust, cheating and obtaining money by false pretense to the tune of 7 million naira. The accused allegedly obtained the sum from a dubious property transaction in Jos Plateau State. The accused person, however, pleaded not guilty when the charges were read to him. Golden Ago reporting for The Eagle.
You're still watching the program, The Eagle. Despite its negative effect on the society, the allure for corruption could be irresistible. The profiles of persons standing trial for corruption in Nigeria cuts across all social strata, and professional standards. But could gender be an issue when it comes to stealing?
Does the cliche, what a man can do, a woman can do better, hold true for corruption? Put bluntly, who is more corrupt, man or woman? Our reporters, Golden Agu and Salamata Habu-Wairi, went to town to seek answers to this poser. Their report is intriguing.
In recent times, the word corruption has formed part of our everyday conversation. It affects every part of the society, and one begins to wonder if this has something to do with gender or other factors. The Eagle team is on the streets of Abuja to find out what people think about this.
You are conversant with the word corruption?
Of course, I'm conversant with the word. I know what it means.
Okay, between a man and a woman, who do you think is more corrupt?
Well, if you want to classify based on gender, in Nigeria here, you never can tell, because the fact is that most of the women have not been given the opportunity to handle political posts. So we can't really say the men are more corrupt than the women.
I can say that men are more corrupt than women.
Okay, why do you say so much?
Because you can see that in the offices that the women held or are still holding, you know, you will find out that few of them, you know, are corrupt in the office or in the offices. But in the side of men, I will say almost all of them. They are so self-centered. They know about themselves and their families. So I know that they are just, they are not serving the populace. That they are just to enrich themselves. But the women have the fear of God. They are a fear of God in women because they are mothers.
I think they both are corrupt.
The number of men found guilty of corrupt practices outweigh the number of women in Nigerian context. But what I discover in essence is that the level, the gravity of the corruption among women, the few women, outweigh that of the men. The in-depth, the level at which they go in the corrupt practices is more of the men. But when we talk about the statistics, the number, in terms of the number, the men outweigh that of the women in Nigerian context.
Though both engage in corrupt practices, men are more corrupt than women. It is because men always try to accumulate wealth by any means, while women always think of their immediate families.
Yeah, I think the men are more corrupt because they tend to have more responsibilities. The women are just there under the men. So the men still tend to do what? Be more corrupt. Yes.
Why do you think so? Should it be that whenever you have a lot of responsibilities that you have the justification to be corrupt?
Yes. You see that the man is the head of the family. And every responsibility comes to the man. So you can look at, if you go to most of these ministries, agencies and government parastatals, all the men you find there, they are all married people. They have to take care of their children, both academically, financially and otherwise. And they have their own personal responsibilities to cater for.
Okay, you think that's the reason why they tend to be more corrupt?
Yes, that's the reason.
Men are more corrupt.
Okay, why do you say so?
And the truth of the matter is that the men folks have this mentality that they can maneuver anything. Okay. There is a point it will get to a woman who want to back out. That's why we see most corruption in Nigeria. The ones that are being committed by women are easy to be discovered. While the men's own, you just play around, and you end up bearing it.
Men is the one who corrupt. Because why? Men, they are the one doing these things to be so very difficult for women. You understand me? This corruption starts from men. Women think back, but man doesn't think back. You understand me? Women understand that my children will eat. Men, it's not like that. We women want everybody to be okay, but men, they want their own pocket to full and go outside the country.
Yes, men are always at the front of corruption, abuse of office and embezzlement of government funds.
That's a difficult question because I couldn't be able to base it on data. But in my personal opinion, from observation, women are more corrupt.
While some people attributed corruption to a particular gender, given various reasons, others have this to say.
To put it in proper perspective, it's not as if Nigeria is the only corrupt nation in the world. There are other corrupt nations. But the difference between Nigeria and some of these developed countries is that the level or the incidence of corruption in such countries is not as high as it is in our own country, whereby it's timized development, it's timized the functioning of the states, you see? So it's not really an issue of whether men are more corrupt than women. I would say it's rather an issue of how can we tackle corruption, okay? And the will to fight corruption has to be there, okay? We're not talking of selective prosecution. We're not talking of some sacred cows are left behind and some others are being prosecuted. Corruption is something that should be tackled head on. And it's not just the government that should fight corruption. You know, in our individual spheres of life, in our workplace, in several places we are, the citizens themselves should insist on transparency. You know, people get the view that it's, oh, only the government should fight corruption. But I don't think so. Everybody's hand must be on deck to tackle the issue of corruption. So it's not really an issue of whether men are more corrupt than women. It's an issue of how can we all tackle corruption. But corruption is everybody, every sex. Men are corrupt, women are corrupt. You know, Muslims, Christians, atheists, everybody, you know. I'm not saying every Nigerian is corrupt. But
given an opportunity.
Exactly. So it seems to be a way of life. You know, settle me, roger me here, give me this. It seems to be a way of life in the country. Well, the new administration has come in. They are showing their intent to prosecute corruption. But the thing about prosecuting corruption, fighting corruption in this country is, it seems to be a slippery slope. Because you are trying to fight corruption, and some people are coming out and crying foul that, oh, you are being vindictive, oh, you are wicked, oh, and then sentiments come in here and there.
Well, I do not think any of them is more corrupt than the other. I would say people are people, you know, regardless of whether it's a man or it's a woman we're talking about here. I would say corruption is something that's eating deep into our society and that it cuts through equally between the sexes.
Well, it depends on individual. You know, a man can be corrupt, a woman can be corrupt.
Generally, I think men are more corrupt than women. Okay. Though it's all based on individual experiences, but the men, if you look at the ratio, men are more corrupt than women because while women, sometimes they have a heart, a compassionate heart, and even if they want to be, they might not be as hardened as the men folks are, but generally the men are more than.
Honestly, Aisha, I can't stop laughing. These are very interesting revelations.
They're funny, Aisha.
Imagine the lady who said men will steal all the money, stack the money in their pockets, and run overseas. Yeah. Very interesting.
I also can't believe all I have heard, especially the respondent who said, because men have so many responsibilities, they engage in corruption. For me, Aisha, that's not an excuse.
No, it's
yes,
not.
Men are supposed to be the breadwinners, but I am sure no man will be proud to say, I raised my family with proceeds of crime. It doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make any sense, definitely. And like Obinna said, all hands must be on deck to check the scourge.
Yes.
The anti-graft agencies need the support of all of us to win the war against corruption in Nigeria. Support the EFCC today for a corruption-free Nigeria. And that's it on the program this week. Do join us same time next week for another interesting edition. To leave a comment, please send your contributions to theeagle@efccnigeria.org or search for us on Google Plus at official EFCC or official EFCCNG@gmail.com.
You can also like our page on facebook.com/official EFCC or follow us on Twitter at official EFCC. And to watch our programs and other activities, please log on to youtube.com/official EFCC. My name is Aisha Mohammed. Bye-bye.
And I am Aisha Gambari. Thank you for watching. God bless Nigeria.